The next evolution of the Yonex mid is here. It's the VCORE Tour F93. Yonex updates their most precise feeling racquet line with Aero Fin Technology, placing little ridges on the inside of the top of the frame to help decrease air resistance and allow you to swing faster. The signature isometric head shape provides a large sweet spot and makes it extra forgiving for a mid-size frame. First up, we're here with Chris, and we both have hit a lot of Yonex mids in our history. I know you've hit a bunch of them, all the way back to the RDX series. How did this one work out for you?
This one was a lot crisper than the RDX 500 mid, really reminding me of the RDX 001 mid. That was a much firmer, crisper feel. This one definitely has that, and because of that, I really enjoyed this racket at net. Totally point and shoot up there. The ball got in and out of the string bed very quickly, and so I found I could, you know, just really punch the ball with depth and good accuracy. And then when I was hitting my drop shots, you know, I could really bleed the pace off the ball, got good feel, so I could hit a nice short angle. As well as on serve too, I like that crisp, fast response. Very easy to accelerate through contact. So I was getting good pace, good access to spin. And then from the baseline again, a little firmer feeling than I would ideally like, but I played very well with this racket. Felt like I was hitting a good medium pace with great consistency, and then when I wanted to step up, I had enough control that led me to do that, be aggressive without missing. So fun play test for me, probably a bit more of a fan of a larger head size these days, but a really nice racket.
Next up, we're here with Carly, and the specs of this racket really fit the bill for what you've been enjoying lately, that faster feeling, precise racket. How did it work out for you?
I really enjoyed it, and mostly because of all the control that it offers. That's one of the things I look for in a racket. But this one especially, with the closed string pattern, that those extra crosses really made it a dense feeling racket. So once I made contact with the ball just really jumped off because it wasn't really ball pocketing much. I found control on all areas of the court, but the place that I liked it the most was volleys, just because there was a little bit of extra power. I struggled a bit at baseline finding depth, and especially with the lack of spin, I found that if I was trying to swing deep in the court, my balls were flying just because I had trouble adding that topspin. But with that net, it still had that great, stable, solid, dense feel. It was easy to maneuver, and I found just a little bit extra pop. So I really enjoyed volleying with that extra power, but overall, I loved the control aspect of this racket.
Next up, we're lucky to have Troy Lara here, fresh off a week and a half down on the demo court at the BNP Paribas Open. I know you're a fan of that traditional style player's frame. Give us your thoughts on this one.
First thing I noticed with this is tons of control and a really maneuverable racket. For being a mid-size, I felt like this was probably the easiest racket to swing for this, you know, head size class. Lots of control, 16 by 21 string pattern, really allowed you to put the ball on a dime. For some reason, I really liked this racket on the two-handed backhand. I felt like I could flatten out the ball, get a lot of pace, hit through the court. But for some reason on the forehand, I felt like the trajectory of the ball was coming off really low. I've been using a 16-19 with the RF97, so I felt like I had to add a little bit of height to my forehand, and it wasn't really dialed in all the time. But love this racket on the two-handed backhand. On serve, great maneuverability, pinpoint precision. I was hitting targets. I liked the flat serve down the middle. I just felt like I wasn't getting much added pace, so that was the downside. Overall, great feel. I think, as Carly said about coming to net with this racket, you get tons of feel, tons of placement, lots of touch, so I really like this racket when charging the net. If I had one knock, I felt like it could use a little bit more plow through, maybe just a slightly higher swing weight, I think would have helped with power. And for the head size being a 93, I would have liked just a little bit more open string pattern. But overall, good racket.
I was also on this play test. I couldn't wait for this play test too, because I've been a huge fan of the Yonex mid for years. And this one just fits right in the line. I loved it. I felt great with it every single time I took it out on the court. It does have a crisper, more modern feel. I thought it reminded me a lot of the previous version, the VCORE Tour 89. But I love that extra 4 inches of head size, because also combined with that isometric head shape, it made it a lot more forgiving, and it felt almost like a 97 or a 98 square inch frame. So it played really forgiving, and that's what jumped out to me the most about this racket. On top of that, you're getting that mid-size precision and feel, which I love. Felt great from every area of the court. Two shots that it really stood out for me, I found when I was really stretched wide on the backhand slice and I was playing defense, the ball, I could get easy depth and neutralize my opponent really well off that shot. And I also felt great on serve. I thought it offered a great blend of power, control, and spin, and I was able to serve really effectively with it. So Awesome mid-size racquet. It's great to see a mid-size racquet that's current, that really can play with the bigger head size frames out there. And if you're a fan of the mid-size racquet, this one's certainly worth a try. For this play test, we used Vocal Cyclone strung down in the low 50 pound range. If you want to learn more, make sure to come to tenniswarehouse.com. Thanks for watching.